This is Ibrox.
After they left, there was kind of a lag between them leaving and a new manager coming in, which in my opinion kind of made it seem even more like a premature decision because I wasn't that sort of ready replacement. But then obviously I think it was maybe a month or so after, it was after the next Old Firm game, Pedro Caixinha gets the job. What were your early impressions of him?
Again, what it was it was absolutely clear on what he wanted to do.
Mm-hmm.
Was it right? In my opinion, no. In my opinion, no. And I think, obviously, again, history does suggest that probably would be the general opinion. But he believed in what he was doing. Again, just on the pro license I had, just had a last month, it was Andre Vias Bosch was speaking on the pro license, another Portuguese coach. And his presentation he put up was very, very similar to what Pedro Caixinha would talk about. A lot of the same language, the same kind of methodology, the same belief in how that it would work, and it did, and it does work. The difference is about how you apply it for me, because nobody's questioning the methodology, nobody's questioning the way to do it, because some of the best coaches in the world are on the same page of how you should do it and how it should be worked. But it's how you apply it. And straight away, I would say, you're talking about first meetings, I would say one of the first meetings, he never lost the dressing room. Like, that never happened. But what he might have had is a dressing room thinking, I'm not sure you get what this club's about. You get what this. And one of the, so that was first few times. Obviously, again, we never had great results over the course of his time. And again, there was another heavy defeat in an Old Firm game towards the end of that season. There was also a semi-final loss, I think it was 2-0, under his tenure, which 2-0, we never laid a glove on them. Again, they were a really good team, managed by one of the top managers in the world, in my opinion.
Yeah.
So it was, again, no great result. And I remember one day he pulled me in to explain what he was trying to do. So we're sitting in the meeting room and he's got all his stuff on, and it was showing me clips of his ex-team in Qatar, Al Gharafa, playing against whoever they were playing in the Qatari league. And it was showing, look, Kenny, look, that's, if we do this and we do that, and I'm watching it, thinking, aye, you know, you're right, you are. I can see exactly. So if what we had worked on, it was either that day or the day before, to what he was showing me was a direct copy a pattern or a phase of play for that game to what we had done in training. The difference being, when they're playing their attacking stuff, they're 2-for-2 and 3-for-3 at the back. I get what you're trying to do, and I can see it. Listen, I can see it by working and what you're showing me there, that how it worked there. But we're going to have 10 men behind the ball.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be 4 or 5, 6 along the 18-yard box. We are not going to have half a pitch to play a 1-2 and run through and go 1-on-1.
Yeah.
It's not going to be that way. And what was the kind of defining moment of trying to, and that, by the way, I tried to speak to him about it to try and let him know that what you maybe watch Motherwell v Partick Thistle will not be what we're facing the next week.
Yeah.
We are not going to face that. It might be a different system, it might be different personnel. Like, there's so many differences that will come in. They might play a different way. They might just launch it against us just to get the ball away for goal. And what defined it for me is we were playing Partick the following week, and we'd done, and the way the methodology worked is, and again, I'm sure Andy's told you, pretty much from a Monday / Tuesday, you would know what the team is for the Saturday.
To the start of the week?
Right at the start of the week. Maybe not the Monday, because it would be a split squad, but that's, he'd done that a lot, and that's something that caused... Not a great, there wouldn't be a divide in the group, but there was that wee starters and non-starters.
Right.
And it was like that for most of the week. So the starters would be doing a recovery type session on the Monday. The non-starters would be doing an extra bit of work, a bit of top up. Come the Tuesday, because it was like a tactical periodization, I think you called it. You were doing work on the Tuesday, which is fine, by the way, with an eye on the Saturday. But what it meant was, he pretty much again took the team that he was going to be doing, and it was going against the other team in a certain drill. So we'd be doing this, and we're set up to play Partick. So we had Partick had played the following week, and I think there were the 4-4-2. I think they were 4-4-2, and Big Connor Salmon was playing left midfield for Partick in the week before. So, needless to say, we prepared by we can get at him on that side because Big Connor's a good big striker. It's not left. He's not a left midfielder in a four. So we had done all our work on all our work. Well, they played a back three that day, not a 4-4-2. Connor Salmon was on the bench, and I think they were like a 3-5-1-1. And it was like a midfielder was like the second striker, so it wasn't even a striker. And that's where you're like, honestly, the whole week was built up to play this against the team playing a certain way. So, by the way, I think we actually drew the game. I think we might have drew 2-2 in that game.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, you know, it's not the reason we drew 2-2, by the way, because I don't care how we played or how they played. We should still win the game. Right, and again, that's no being disrespectful to Partick at that time. I mean, I played for Partick, you know, it's no being disrespectful at all. But Rangers, 99 times out of 100, 9 times out of 10, should beat Partick no matter what. No matter what, yeah, there'll be the odd game or games where things go against you, maybe we are levels. I mean, I've been on the other team playing against Rangers. What you're looking for is your levels are there, Rangers drop a wee bit because they know that up for the game and it becomes a more level match.
Yeah.
Right? That's what you're hoping for. Well, on that day, the prep again, but in terms of his preparation and how he tried to work, that kind of summed it up a wee bit. Well, the whole fucking week was pretty much pointless, you know, because we're constantly worked through this periodization that he'd wanted to work, worked on specific movements to go against a set way, that's not how it was. So, and again, it works. I'm not saying it doesn't work, but sometimes it's about how apply it. It's maybe about how you treat people, not necessarily how good a tactician we are. So it was, listen, it never worked. It never worked, obviously. It led to him leaving 4 months into the next season.
Yeah.
I think he had been at the club totally 7 months, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
And that was that. Obviously, what happened between me and him, again, is nothing actually happened. He just decided to make a fucking point. I became a scapegoat to another poor fucking Old Firm performance. one that I never even played in, by the way, because I was on the bench.
Right.
But that was that. But listen, I never ever had any issue with him. Trained every day, like I always have, trained hard. Then he eventually left and obviously I managed to get back in.
Because it was strange you say that there was definitely a clear sort of attempt to him to phase you out, which was a surprise given the season before. I actually think you had played the most games of MD in the squad. And at that point, you must have been about 36, 37. So to go from having a guy who played the most games, I think I've got it wrote down. I think you were the top goal scorer as well. And then it seemed as though he kind of tried to phase you out almost. I don't know if this is my words, not yours, obviously. It seemed like a guy who had like a lack of self-awareness. And maybe I don't know if it was an arrogance, but he didn't want to allow a senior guy like yourself to sort of offer your opinion, even though you'd clearly had loads of experience in that league, so you would kind of know these sort of things before he would?
Well, like I say, there was only maybe one or two occasions that we spoke about this kind of stuff, and I gave him a view. There was never any disagreement. There was never any, it was, again, I'm trying to offer you, if you're asking me, then I'm going to give you an answer. And I gave him my view on what I thought. And it was there. There was no disagreement or any, even a debate. It was just he's asked a question, I gave an answer to a question. And again, what then happened, obviously, after that Old Firm game, like you say, I don't even know. I didn't even know what happened because I went to see him. Like, I genuinely, I've spoken about this before. After that game, again, this is hand on heart, I knew it was coming. We played Hamilton on the Friday night and I knew it was coming. And I just, you can just feel, and I've been in football a long time, and I've got a fair gauge on how people react in certain situations. And I knew there was something wasn't right. So I actually spoke to him on the Tuesday. Said, "You all right, Gaffer?" He's like, "Yes, yes, fine. Right. You're acting weird. You're acting weird with me. You're kind of looking at me now. You're walking past the hall. Like, it's just weird." Mm-hmm. He's like, no, Kenny, no. And he's all smiles and like, okay. Hunt. No word I phone David Weir. Says David, the son, they're on here. Phone Walter Smith. Walter. And this I say to him, I'm getting left out on Friday night. He went, nah, fucking no way, Kenny. No, but Gaffer, I'm telling you, there's something no right here with this fucker. There's something no right. He's went, right, okay. So I ran through there. He went, go and see him. Go and see him. Again, I went, Gaffer, I went to see him today. He went, go and see him again. Get him to tell you if there's something wrong. Because it's clear that clearly there is. I went, right, no ball, Gaffer, no ball. Went to see him. No, no, nothing wrong. I went, Gaffer, come on, there's something wrong. Like you're acting differently. No, not at all. Sure enough, Thursday comes, squad goes up, no in the squad. If there was nothing wrong, why would you not say, I'm leaving you at the squad?
Because that is something wrong for a guy like yourself who's played all the games.
Why would you not do that? Why would you not do it? So anyway, the squad, so I go straight through it and I says, Gaffer, what's going on? Why am I not in the squad? He went, oh, this is just one decision. I went, but why? He went, no reason. I went, no, there has to be a reason. You've made a decision. If it's one decision, what's the reason behind the decision? Mm-hmm. No, this is just one decision. I was like, fucking hell. Just okay, no problem. Yeah. No problem. All the best, Gaffer. Listen, hope we win. Soon after 1-4-1, 3-1, whatever it was, boys were great. Won next week. Get beat in the semi-final against Motherwell. To the extent, by the way, I felt I had to ask if I could actually go and watch the game because he was acting really super weird. And I wanted him to actually allow me to watch the game. I didn't want to turn up to the game if, in case he thought I was there for some fucking other reason. And
you actually felt that excluded. You felt you had to ask if you could go and watch the game.
I didn't know how to go. I went and seen him. I said, Gaffer, do you mind if I come to the game? He went, oh, of course, you can come on the bus. You come in. No, it's fine because Waldo was injured and Nico was injured. So I knew they were going to the game.
Yeah.
So I didn't want to no go to the game. Mm-hmm. But I knew if I'd went to the game, he would feel there for different reasons. You know, this is how it was fucking weird, you know, really, really weird. So I asked him, do you mind if I come to the game, support the boys? He went, no, of course. So we went to the game. Obviously, we lost the game 2-0, semi-final. And then we drew the Kilmarnock on the Wednesday night. And then, that was that. It was gone. Fire's raging, I'm shaking. You wanna go out, I wanna stay in. Wow.